Welcome to Secure Freedom Radio. This is Frank Affney, your host and guide for what I think of as an intelligence briefing on the war for the free world. In the front lines of that war, and indeed in the front lines of other facets of it, but at the moment in the United States Congress, is our first guest. He is Representative John Fleming, a medical doctor by training, now representing the people of the 4th District of Louisiana. He is a member of the House Armed Services Committee and also the Natural Resources Committee, chairs its subcommittee on fisheries and so on. He's also the co-founder or prominent member of a number of other caucuses relevant to our present topic. And I'm very pleased to have him back. Welcome, Congressman. Thanks so much for taking the time to join us.
Thanks, Frank. Yeah, absolutely.
Well, I'm canvassing as many folks as I can get my hands on, both on and off Capitol Hill, about the, well, I call it the Obama bomb deal. What did you make of it? And what do you think its prospects are in your chamber?
Well, I think it's a terrible deal. I mean, Mr. Netanyahu, Prime Minister of Israel, I think really clarifies that for us very quickly. Remember that we had a vote, I don't know, a month or two ago, on whether to have congressional oversight of this. I voted against that, and the reason was because it created a very, very low threshold for the president to get his way. Instead of a two-thirds vote for a treaty, he actually we have to have a two-thirds vote to override his veto in both houses. What's the chance of that? I would say slim to none. And we really hurt our negotiating position by doing that, because basically the president didn't have to worry about disapproval. He could pretty much give in to anything he wanted so that he could get this notch on his belt and be able to claim that he's brought peace in our time, when in fact it's a very bad deal, but it'll probably be years out before we see just how bad it is.
You know, one of the other things that's aggravating about this, Congressman Fleming, is that the president went yesterday, or sent his minions, to the United Nations to begin the process of unraveling the sanctions regime there and in Europe, even before the 60 days that are provided for in this rigged game, as you say. And I commend you for voting against the Corker-Cardin bill. I think it was a mistake, too. How do you think members of Congress, and for that matter, constituents in the 4th District of Louisiana, are likely to take this gambit that the president isn't going to wait for whatever congressional assent might be forthcoming? He's going to steal a march on you and get the bulk of the sanctions already lifted by the UN.
I think they'll be outraged. At least my constituents will be in Louisiana. But they won't be surprised. This is consistent with a lot of things this president has done. He comes to the aid of our adversaries, and he turns his back on our friends. So what's new about this? Again, he's basically, in my opinion, stabbing our trusted ally, our most cherished ally, Israel, in the back. And he's giving everything they essentially want to Iran, which is a nation that sponsors terrorism that has killed thousands of Americans. They're just completely shocked, but not surprised, again, because this is a repeated behavior by this president.
Yeah. You know, one particularly egregious example of the president's, willingness to embrace our enemies and undermine our friends, Congressman John Fleming, as you know from your service on the Strategic Forces Subcommittee and the House Armed Services Committee, and also as a member of the Missile Defense Caucus, is the abandonment for a time of a missile defense in Europe. We're now hearing the Russians say, well, we've now taken care of this missile, or at least the nuclear threat from Iran. Mr. President, we call on you to scrap the sort of substitute system that he had talked about putting in there. Do you anticipate the president will now take that step as well, leaving Europe, as well as us, substantially vulnerable to these sorts of threats which abide?
Well, I wouldn't be surprised, but again, I pray that he doesn't do that, because we also know that there's nothing in this deal that prevents Iran from locking on to new ballistic, intercontinental ballistic technology. So their ability to deliver missiles both within the region and on an intercontinental basis is going to get much better. So it would be shocking to think that we would leave our friends in Europe vulnerable. And so what is going to have to happen, I'm afraid, is that each and every country is going to have to really open its wallet and purchase missile defense technology and also become a nuclear state for deterrence. We know that, for instance, Saudi Arabia and other countries in the region are already working on doing that, knowing that this was coming down the pike. So this president, who wants to be a anti-proliferation president when it comes to nuclear arms, is actually going to step it up a huge amount. And again, I just pray that he doesn't try to remove more missile defense in Europe from our NATO and our aligned partners there.
You know, speaking of deterrence, Congressman Fleming, we have allowed, unfortunately, particularly under this president, our own nuclear forces to decline rather dramatically, really atrophy, as well as have, you know, arms control induced cuts. What is your thought as you watch what the Russians are up to in Ukraine at the moment and making very bellicose noises against some others in Europe, including some of our NATO allies on their periphery? Is our deterrent adequate, and do you fear, as some have said on my program, that we may be at the threshold of miscalculations that could result in a nuclear war in Europe if we're not careful?
Yes. I'll take you back to Marine General Joseph Dunford, who's a nominee for Joint Chiefs of Staff. He was asked, what is, in your opinion, our major threat out there? And he said it was Russia. You remember that Romney said that in the 2012 debates, and he was mocked by President Obama as saying that he had a Cold War mentality. Well, look, Putin is doing everything he can to reconstruct the old Soviet Union, but in a modern way, not under communism, but certainly under a totalitarian government. And Russia is rapidly modernizing its military. They're already violating the INF treatment, intermediate range nuclear arms. And of course, they've incurred into Ukraine, took over Crimea. I mean, you know, they're expansionist, and yet our president barely even notices it. And then we have the rebalance to the Pacific, which I think is a good idea, but I don't think we should be taking away resources from Europe. I think we're actually zigging when we should be zagging. We're cutting our army another 40,000 troop strength, when in fact the world is a more dangerous place every day.
It is indeed. Speaking of which, and again tying into your work on the House Armed Services Committee, Congressman Fleming, and also your efforts on behalf of missile defense, a development that is very concerning to me is happening in both the Russian arsenal and the Chinese, namely the advent of hypersonic maneuvering warheads, which will be designed explicitly to try to defeat our missile defenses. Could you just talk quickly about your sense as to what a threat that represents and what we should be doing about it?
Well, yes. I mean, obviously, our missiles are designed for conventional ballistic and intercontinental ballistic missiles, and there's things that can be done to defeat that, as you say, hypersonic, traveling at speeds that are faster than what our defense can really provide. Also, multiple warheads, the ability to redirect after something is launched, where it can have an abnormal pathway. And so the question is, well, do we really have an edge in technology over China and Russia? And the answer to that is they are rapidly catching up to us, and in some areas they're surpassing us, particularly Russia, when it comes to technology. So we've enjoyed a huge technology edge really almost since World War II, Frank, and that edge, that gap, is collapsing rapidly. Even the Generation 5 fighters, both Russia and China, are catching up with us and maybe surpassing us on that. And meanwhile, we're squabbling over unimportant things that we're spending money on military, when in fact there's huge problems that we're going to be up against. And we'll go through that same cycle. When we get in a conflict, we'll be behind, we'll lose the edge, and that means American lives.
It does. It may even mean defeat. Congressman John Fleming, your insights into these matters is really important and valued by our audience. Thank you for taking the time to join us. I hope you'll do so again very soon. Next up, intelligence professional Fred Flights joins us to talk about President Obama's press conference yesterday and alternatives to the disastrous Obama-bomb deal.